As you can see, these copings are taller than the closed tray copings. Make sure your patient can open wide enough to be able to place and remove this style coping. In an open tray technique, the tray is first verified for fit and to identify the location of the impression coping. The tray will have to be adjusted to allow the top of the impression coping to pop through. An acrylic burr is utilized to create a perforation in the tray. In this second scenario, the open tray or direct impression coping is secured to the implant by engaging the internal connection and again, hand tightening into place. This style coping will be removed from the mouth at the same time as the impression tray. The open tray impression coping has various undercuts to ensure it stays stable within the impression. This style coping also comes with a long guide pin that should be utilized during this impression. This allows the top of the pin to pop out through the impression tray for easier identification and removal. Again, radiographic confirmation is recommended to ensure there is no interferences of either hard or soft tissues and that the coping is fully seated. This is my impression technique of choice, as the coping stays in the impression, leaving less room for error. However, as you can see, these copings are taller than the closed tray copings. Make sure your patient can open wide enough to be able to place and remove this style coping. Once the open tray impression coping is seated, the adjacent contacts are evaluated and adjusted if needed. Same as before, you can visualize nice broad contacts and a great path of insertion without the need for adjustment. In this example, the emergence profile of the impression coping was again customized by adding flowable composite. As a reminder, this will prevent soft tissue collapse, allowing the transfer of the soft tissue profile that was created either with a custom healing abutment or provisional restoration. In an open tray technique, the tray is first verified for fit and to identify the location of the impression coping. The tray will have to be adjusted to allow the top of the impression coping to pop through. An acrylic burr is utilized to create a perforation in the tray. The tray is tried in again to ensure the impression coping is coming through the center of the hole. After verification, I like to add a piece of blue wax over the top of the hole to help hold the impression material in place. This wax makes locating the top of the coping much easier. Now we are ready for our impression. Just as with the previous technique, a lighter viscosity PVS material is syringed intraorally around the soft tissue and adjacent teeth while the tray is filled with a heavier viscosity PVS. Keep in mind, for an open tray technique, either a polyvinyl siloxane or polyether material can be utilized. Polyether is much more rigid compared to polyvinyl siloxane, so be sure to mind any undercuts that are present in the arch when using this material. As the impression material sets, I like to locate the top of the guide pin by pushing on the blue wax with either my fingertip or the handle of the mouth mirror. After the impression material is fully set, the guide pin is completely unscrewed before the tray is removed from the mouth. Once it's removed, take a look at the impression. You can see the impression coping stayed in the tray. No need to reinsert the coping afterwards. The implant analog can then be attached to the impression coping either by the clinician chair side or by the laboratory technician prior to model work being completed. This is Dr. Taylor Manalili with Glidewell. I hope you can go ahead and capture your Han impressions both accurately and comfortably from now on. Stay tuned for more clinical videos in the future.